Welcome back to 101 with Ivan Thomas. Okay, look, let's cut to the chase. It's been a wild 2020, and now we got something, a show that I just had to come in, call my guys to produce. This is a live episode, a special episode with special guest, the auditor, state auditor, Kathy McGuiness. We're here to talk about the legalization of marijuana. And so we want your input. We're recording this as a podcast too. So I have a special guest, Shay Alexander on the phone, who is the marijuana connoisseur of all sorts. So she's going to, co-host with me on that. Shay, how you doing today?
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
Appreciate you. All right, let's hop on into it. You ready, Shay?
I'm ready.
All right. So again, today's special guest is the Delaware State Auditor, Kathy McGuiness. Kathy, welcome, welcome, welcome. How are you?
Wonderful. Thanks for having me. Happy 2021.
I know that's right. It's been a crazy year.
It has.
How you and your office been holding up?
Very well. So I have a tremendous staff. I'm very proud of a great team, and we're working hard, as you can see.
Yeah, and I can see. So before we even get into the legalization of marijuana, let's talk about this website and this app that you came in and revamped, and now everyone is on it and has brought a new light to the auditor's office.
So I was sworn in January of 2019, and the fraud app was there before me. But what we did is we upgraded our hotline team and the way we log things and categorize and discuss. And you could always go to auditor.delaware.gov for fraud. You can call 1-800-55-FRAUD. But we also developed fraud.delaware.gov, which is a mobile app for your device.
Right.
Most people have a mobile device these days.
Yeah.
And we have seen a huge uptick in the reporting of fraud.
Right.
For example, as of July 1, 2020, we have had almost 500 calls or communications in regards to fraud.
Right.
That's in about 6 months.
Yeah.
That's more than years combined.
That is a lot.
That's a lot.
That's
We're
a lot of people being. That's a lot of people. One being informed.
Yes.
And a lot of people telling on what's going on.
They are telling on each other. But the good news is they know there's an auditor. They know there's a hotline. They know we engage. They know we're trying. Not everything ends up there. It
right.
lands somewhere else. And
right.
we work together with other agencies where they might refer something to us, we refer to them.
Right.
But we've done so many good things. We did their first ever statewide risk assessment survey 2 years in a row now.
Nice.
And that helps develop our audit plan and what we can and cannot do with our resources.
Okay.
We did something really special. Put together a few states and led a national audit, which has never been done in the history of this country.
Right.
And 14
That's
states
major.
Participating. Three of us have already completed our audit, and the
okay.
rest will be rolling out this year. That's a big deal.
Yeah.
It's a very big deal. So we are, we're working on a national level too here. So people should be proud of their Delaware's auditor's office.
You've been working
yes.
since January.
As I say, I have proof right here and here.
That gray?
It's a little, hey, I hope you can't see it. Can you see it?
Well,
let me go like this.
Now you've been working on some other things as well.
Yeah.
And this is the legalization of recreational marijuana.
Mm-hmm.
With all that going on, and you're getting a lot of people that's really in your corner with this.
Sure. It's interesting. I mean, this office has always put out special reports, and it's in the code that we may do so. And
okay.
For years.
Right.
For example, I think one of the popular ones is the fire report.
Okay.
Volunteer fire service. And that comes out once a year annually. And we put that out not long ago, and it spoke to our volunteer fire service save us about $244 million a year. That's
okay.
a big deal for Delaware taxpayers.
Yeah.
This report speaks to we could generate $43 million in a year.
Wow.
With legalization, but let's be clear, for recreational, adult use.
Right.
Adult over 21 is what we looked at.
Now, before we go any further, I want you to give your disclaimer.
Yes.
That you are not promoting the use of.
Absolutely not.
So I'll let you rock out.
They're very different.
Okay.
Everyone thinks I'm promoting it. No. The regulation and the taxation, as we see our neighboring states do it, we have to be able to be in the game as well.
Yeah, as the first state, we can't be the last.
We can't be the last. Thank
right,
you.
Right, right. So $43 million in the first year. What do you project in the second year?
We just looked at the first year.
Okay.
And there's been a lot of questions, as you know. I mean, this is all over, not only our country, but the world, this
right.
report. There's a lot of opportunity, we'll say. We looked at stats. We took, you know, 792,000 adults in Delaware, mm-hmm. and then we estimate 13.07% admit to using that. And that's from a SAMHSA report in 2015-16. Since then, very recently, a new one came out. So that number means that that number could be higher.
Right.
23 million could be higher.
Right.
So then we took that number, which is a little over 100,000,
mm-hmm.
and we chose the 20, So between Colorado and Washington, and they already have legalization in their state, you look at their numbers, we took an average, and it's about $2,000 a year someone would use for marijuana.
Okay.
Okay, so then you times that by a 20% tax rate, which we really don't want to get married to or worry about that much, because this is up to the legislature, what tax rate they want to choose.
Right.
And that's where we came out with the $43
million. Wow.
Yeah.
Shay, what you got over there, Shay?
So Zach from Laurel wants to know, do you really think $43 million is achievable?
I do. I think it's not only achievable, I think it's a conservative estimate. And I think that it could actually be higher. Because number one, as I just said, 13% of folks, of adults admit to using it. That number could be higher.
Let me tell you something.
Okay?
You said his name was Zach?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So Zach, look, let me tell you, I think is reachable. This is a hell of a year.
Yeah.
That alone, I'm gonna leave it right there. Okay, heck of a year. Are you getting a lot of people that's really with you on this?
Yes, I would say the majority are. There are a few people that are very angry. They don't understand that people like. I've had some questions where, well, people are gonna drive and they're gonna be driving high, and I'm like,
no,
they're driving high now, or they're too tired to go out and drive. I don't know.
Right.
But I mean, we have to understand it's already there on the illicit market. It's already there.
Right.
Let's tax it, let's regulate it, and let's be competitive in our market from a fiscal and economic standpoint.
From a fiscal and economic standpoint.
Yeah.
I can understand that. What needs to change to make this happen?
Well, we've done our job.
Mm-hmm.
Auditor's office has run their numbers, and then we give this report, and this report goes to everyone, the public as well. And it's up to the General Assembly what they'd like to do. But at least they have more information than they had before.
Very important.
Yeah.
Very important.
Information.
I think with Jersey legalizing it, that we're probably a step behind.
Pennsylvania's looking at it. You know,
yeah. We're a step away right now. So what happens, and I know this is one of the questions, and I'm going to go to my social media from the last time that I posted. What do you think should happen to the people that got arrested for marijuana with the little charges?
Well, decriminalization. Delaware's done a great job as far as decriminalization, mm-hmm. and expungement. But this is the next natural step. This is the next project. You know, this is a way to have that discussion now.
Right.
Now it's time.
Right.
Now it's time. And, you know, prohibition is not keeping any, it's not making people not use it.
It's true.
And it certainly has affected color, communities of color far more.
Yes. Yes.
Prohibition has.
You can say that one more time so the people in the back can hear.
Communities of color have been affected far more.
Yeah, and getting crazy charges with
mm-hmm.
it. Wow.
Mm-hmm. So I think this is like, this helps reform our criminal justice system, and it's an honest way.
Yeah, I'm just sitting here looking at the numbers again. Delaware adult population, 792,111 adult use, 13%. That's a nice size number.
And as I said earlier, that 13% could be higher. And also, maybe people spend more than $2,000 a year.
Right.
I'm just saying, these are very conservative estimates.
Right. What else do you want people to know about this?
I just think it's time to have that honest discussion. I think mm-hmm. this actually has a social justice ramifications as well. And we need to just know that there are in this report, as mm-hmm. many reports, I will have auditors comment or some things, but this data is independent. It's sound methodology,
mm-hmm.
and this is information and good research, and I stand by it, which is independent of my opinion.
Right, right.
So I'm just giving the information.
Public opinion. What are they saying about it?
Oh, well, we already know at least 60% of Delawareans approve of legalization. I believe it's 68%.
Wow, that's a high number.
Change. I'm not in the minority here.
Right.
This is how it's going.
Wow.
Yes.
So
very different.
Wow. And I'm saying what, 2 out of 3 Americans support it.
Mm-hmm.
It's
bipartisan now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you actually have more Republicans going for this than Democrats.
Than before. Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah.
Shay, what you got over there, Shay?
So a Wilmington resident would like to know, what do you say to those in law enforcement and healthcare opposed to legalization because they believe it's a dangerous thing?
Well, I think that first I would hope they go and read our report. And then I'd hope they look at the references that we cited. Because
right.
we did do our research and due diligence. And it has, actually studies have been shown that where it's legalized, you have less opioid use. So that should make the person who's the healthcare official, you know, feel more comfortable. Keep in mind, I'm also a registered pharmacist. We dispense it in a pill form for those with HIV and cancer.
Right.
So it's been being dispensed legally with a prescription for years.
Mm-hmm.
As I do think that there needs to be a conversation, and law enforcement must be included so that a proper, thoughtful legislation that has the correct framework can be involved here.
Are you getting a lot of police officers that, what is the
consensus? I've had a couple that are not very thrilled.
Okay.
Yeah, and there's a few that get it. They
right.
understand, like, look, they're doing it in other states.
Yeah.
We can do it here, too.
Yeah.
So, again, it's time for that thoughtful conversation.
Wow. Shay, you got anything else over there? Anyone else?
Let me take a look.
Shay, what is your opinion? What you think?
I think it's great. I say go for it all the way.
Oh, dear.
Shay's a smoker. She's a smoker.
She sounds like it. I don't know, but you know, I'm excited, and I really want to, like, I don't know if there's more questions to field, but I really want to thank you for giving me this opportunity, because this is just another way that our office, my awesome team, my tremendous team, is able to show value.
Yeah, yeah.
And we look forward to, you know, being a partner in good governance.
No, thank you for coming. I'm just going through, I'm looking down because I'm going through the charts and everything. And one thing that I definitely want to talk about a little bit more is about the economic potential that this can have over this wonderful state we live in.
Oh, we believe at least 1,400 jobs over 5 years. Again, we look at the other states and how they got their, you know, data or what rate they're using according to their working population. So these are all formulas.
Yeah.
And they're in the report.
Right.
And so we believe 1,400 to 2,400 in 5 years. That's a big job creator.
Yeah, not just that it could bring in $43 million first year. We're also talking about jobs that it can bring in, too.
Yes.
Jobs such as what?
All kinds of jobs. Working from in the industry, being employed at maybe, you know, one of the shops or, you know, you already have dispensaries right now for medical marijuana.
Right.
So this would probably branch out on a larger, more, maybe small business or chains, et cetera.
Okay.
So there's all kinds of businesses that could grow out of this, no pun.
Boy's a lot of puns today, I'll tell you that much. I'll tell you a lot.
I mean, you should have worn your green Masters jacket when you won the Masters.
Yeah, now the people will be like, yo, he smoked weed too. Actually, I don't, okay? So let me put it on air like that. But what else do you want the people to know about this?
I think I'd really like them to go to auditor.delaware.gov. And what we've made easy, one of my initiatives is we found out if things are too technical, people aren't going to read them. Right?
Right. I agree.
They're not going to read
it. I agree.
So what we've done with our technical and non-technical reports now is we have a one page, I call it the hot sheet. What we did, why we did it, here's our finding, here's our recommendations. If there are any, hyperlink to the report.
Mm-hmm.
So you can decide, wow, I really don't want to read about that nursing home wage survey, but wow, I do really want to read about something with lottery or with legalization of marijuana. So you can pick and choose what you want. It's very simple to navigate on our website.
Mm-hmm.
Please go there. Please sign up. I'm sure there's something for everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
I need to bring in Zoe from where's she from, Shay? What organization, you remember?
Zoe Patchell.
The cannabis industry.
Institute.
She's doing a lot. She's been doing a lot, lot from the very beginning of trying to get it legalized here in Delaware.
I think that's a nonprofit.
Yeah, okay. They're moving. All right, I'm gonna make sure I put their website and their information below so you can check it out if you'd like to support. Kathy.
I really thought you were gonna say I really wanted to bring in my new COVID puppy. let your puppy play with us.
Oh,
but
where's
he didn't do that. She's not here.
Oh,
they locked her out.
Oh, yeah, they locked her out.
Let the listeners know.
Yeah, so we
need to know the truth.
We got a COVID puppy.
Yes.
Support. Oh, Shay, what you got?
So this isn't a question, but it is a comment from Christine Hastings. She says, I love this woman's tenacity and commitment to her home in general, no matter the subject matter.
Thank you.
Oh, what's her name?
Christine Hastings.
Thank you, Christine.
Thanks, Christine.
We're working hard for you.
You working.
We're working.
Yo, you are really, you're doing a lot. You're doing a lot.
We're on the map. We're on the national map. I'm on 4 national committees. I panel every other week.
Wow, panelists. Are you serious? Mm-hmm. What else have you learned about marijuana, legalizing marijuana, that you probably would have missed?
Well, you know, I knew it from a pharmaceutical background, so I kind of knew it from that area. This was, for me, quite an eye-opener on the as far as the fiscal opportunities. And we all know things in the public. We all know our neighboring states are doing it. We all know certain states have already legalized it. But for that equation to come out that way, that was really
a game changer.
It was. I mean, there are communities that have been left behind or have been penalized, some more than others. And here's an opportunity where we could have some funds, maybe do a little bit of repair here. I mean, there's a lot of opportunity for these funds. We want to make sure that your funds are spent the way they should be, because we know that everybody has different needs and causes that are near and dear to their heart, correct?
Right.
You might care about the library. That might be on the top of your list. The next person might be very in tune with, gardening. The next person might be very in tune with another service that they really need. Maybe they have someone who's disabled and they need this service. We need to make sure that these services are available for our Delawareans. Mm-hmm. So how do we do that? Well, everything takes money, right?
Right.
And it's prioritizing what we're going to fund where. So here's an opportunity. And we have to manage change, because change is happening around us. I've said this for years. If you don't go ahead and try and steer the change and just let it happen, you end up with whatever you get.
What happens if it doesn't?
We will be left behind. We will be left behind because other states are doing it around us right now. I mean, the governor, Wolf of Pennsylvania, is talking about it. And, you know, this is it is what it is. So let's make it safe. Let's tax it. Let's regulate it. Let's get it off the illicit market. And let's make some money for it, and then put money into programs that we also sorely need.
Wow. 2021, and we're close to legalizing marijuana in
Maybe.
The state of Delaware.
It's not up to me.
Yeah, right.
I just do the numbers. Here you go. It's up to the legislature. They can do how they see fit.
All right. So right now, I'm going to give you your chance to post that case to them. What would you say to them?
I would say that, again,
Look at your camera.
In these tough times, and we don't know, they're very uncertain. And we
right.
can say that for the truth.
Right.
I believe that this is an opportunity. We do not want to be left behind. The first state does not want to be last. And there are many good places, including the auditor's office that works for everybody, that could use a little bit of funding, a little bit of resources. And here's an opportunity to get with the curve and not be left
behind. $43 million is a huge purse.
A lot of money.
On something that people are already doing.
Yes.
Yeah. And like what the record said, no one ever died of marijuana. I don't
That recall. Was really interesting, that video you showed me. I've never seen that.
Yeah.
Is that like a series?
It used to be a series, but they took them off because
of that video?
Because he was telling the truth on a lot of things.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
And what was it?
Adam ruins everything.
And I guess you can't see it anymore.
No, I don't know. But it's online. It's on YouTube.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, Kathy, thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you for having me. It was wonderful.
Be sure next time you got something that you want to cause a ruckus about.
I'm not causing a ruckus.
No, excuse me.
Information.
That you want to give information out to
there
the masses.
There you go. I like that.
Okay.
Okay.
That you stop by.
I will. Thank you very much.
All right.
All right.
It's your main man, Ivan Thomas, and I want to know what you think. Should they legalize recreational marijuana in Delaware?
For adult use.
For adult use. Very important to say that. Put your comment below and make sure you tag Kathy in it as well. All right. Make sure you stay tuned, because on Mondays, Good Morning Wilmington. On Sundays, 101 Ivan Thomas and the Chef Dana Cooking Show. But most of all, if you have a young one, DETV Kids, where we partner with United Way of Delaware for Storybook Corner and our storytellers shows. So we're getting out of here. We're going to have some more conversation about legalizing. All right, I'll see you when I see you. It's your main man, Ivan Thomas. Thank you so much.